is a film festival that is held in Utah yearly. It is in Park City, Utah. It's a great time. There's a lot of panels with directors. Get to meet some actors. Awesome food. And Randolph High School goes there. I've been going there for a few years now. Every year for a field trip. Great time overall.
What are some of your expectations for Sundance?
Well, I'm obviously hoping to see some really good films. Like right now, just according to the trailers and the descriptions, it looks like there's some really good movies out there.
Well, I'm really excited, hoping it'll be super fun. Want to see some good movies and see Park City. I've never been to Utah, so that's exciting.
I am looking forward to the films that they have this year. I'm looking forward to just the experience of Sundance. As a teacher, I just like seeing my students experience new things in film and get to talk to professionals in the industry.
I'm pretty pumped. Let's see some cool movies. Hot tub, priority.
My expectations for Sundance this year is we're gonna see a lot of great movies. Hopefully see some snow out there. It's always nice seeing some snow out in Utah. Eat some good food, see some celebrities.
I'm hoping to see some awesome movies. Have a lot of fun at the house. The house looks awesome. Hot tub, lots of hot tub.
Good weather, good times back at the house. That you guys get into lots of movies that you want to see, that you enjoy what you see, and that you meet lots of famous people on the street.
And are there any movies in particular that you're looking forward to seeing?
No, not in particular.
Top of my list is Bushwick. And then probably Wilson and Brigsby Bear. A lot of movies I'm excited to see.
Bushwick looked good. I think that Wilson movie looked good.
Definitely The Discovery and The Big Sick looks pretty good. And I don't feel at home in this world anymore.
Bushwick, Mudbound, and Wilson.
Yellowbirds looks really good. Wilson looked funny.
I don't feel at home in this world anymore. Good one. Mudbound. And I saw the trailer for Wilson yesterday. It looks really good, so it's probably up there.
Right now on my list, my top movie would probably be Mudbound. And then after that, I'd have to put Wilson because I always do love my comedies. And then probably Yellowbirds after that. So those would be my top three.
And how have you prepared for this trip?
Well, as a group, we've all participated in the bake sales, just trying to raise that little bit of extra money.
All right, so we are $2 away from getting $800 for our Sundance, and that's going to help a lot because that's $100 off of everyone's freaking, things.
Ticket.
So it's that's going to help
these
a lot.
These bake sales are crazy. This is the last cookie.
Look. Cake pops. So many cake pops. Oh, yeah. So the bake sales obviously have been big success, so that's good.
Okay, so and then,
I want a cookie.
Yay! 800!
As far as my preparation, I think we're looking into recipes and menus.
I've gotten clothes together and been making a lot of stuff for the bake sale.
We tried to get ticket packages. I was unsuccessful, but we tried to.
Well, I've looked at the Sundance website a lot and read the descriptions of the movies, but that's about it. So I should probably start packing.
Ooh, I got a sick new jacket for Christmas. spending money from my father. Thank you, John.
I prepared by booking the lodging, getting all the tickets, going all through the red tape that the school makes you go through to get a trip like this going. So this started back in July. When we had to book the lodging for it, because if you don't book the lodging literally more than 6 months in advance, you're not going to get lodging. And then after that, it was the airfare and could we get a direct flight and the price difference and all of that stuff, and then the parent meeting and the informational meetings we've had, the bake sales, I mean, all of those things came together. So there's a lot of preparation that goes into this, and it's that nobody ever really thinks about or sees.
All right, everyone, this is the Sundance 2017 trip. We just got in the bus. Mr. Fitting's all ready to go. He has the most excitement out of all of us, right?
Always.
So much energy.
Oh, yeah. Any last words before we leave New Jersey?
We're all gonna die.
Bye.
Stop.
Hey, Jason, are you excited?
Oh, yeah, I am.
Oh. Hey, Ryan, are you excited?
Yeah.
Hey, Emma, are you excited?
Yeah. Okay.
Hey, bald man, you excited? Yeah, he is.
Here.
Yeah.
Ryan, we're here. Mr. Finning, we're here.
I am excited.
Living in the street. Oh, there's a solution.
Ryan. Hey, that's your suitcase, right?
Yeah.
Oh, there's mine. Boss. Yeah.
Yeah, we were smart. We put ours in the plane, but yeah, these guys, they couldn't because there's no room.
Look at Mr. G. Waiting slowly up. Nope, that's not his.
First day of Sundance, yeah, woohoo! Most thrilling part, getting the luggage.
All right, we're in style, okay.
Yo, this is Sundance 2017. We just got in, actually, okay. An hour ago.
Yeah, you know what we is. Sometimes you gotta stay in. Welcome to my.
All right, so here we are. We are in the house now. We're getting ready to do a volunteer tour. So right now we're taking off our shoes. We want to keep this place nice and neat. But any second now we're gonna go in.
Come on in. I'm Hunter Co. And this is my MTV crib. We got a little a nook area.
We got our
very
pad.
Nice sink pad. Morning comes and you know that you wanna stay. Bunk beds, very rustic. Laundry your own laundry needs. Oh yeah. Check out this kitchen. Look at this. I call this a fridge. Feeling tired after a long day at the Sundance 2017 Film Festival? Follow me to the master bedroom. Check out the master bedroom. Man, this is the life. We got a bathroom over here. You guys ready? Walk-in shower. Oh. We got a nice, very, very beautiful bathroom right in here. Nice, lovely beds. Oh, very nice.
Where do you go to the living room area?
Come on.
What's up, guys? We're in timeout.
Mr. Nice. Finning, can we come out of timeout?
Awesome. And then there's Raisin Bran. Should I explain that story?
Yes.
All right, so we're in the supermarket and we're passing the cereal. We're in charge of getting breakfast. And we're getting like four cereals. We're like, we'll cap it at four, all right? So we have like three of the cereals. And the fourth one, I'm like, we should get Raisin Bran because I remember having a conversation with Mr. Finning a couple days prior. Right, it was something about Raisin Bran, and I was like, I'm pretty sure he wants Raisin Bran. So we pick up the Raisin Bran, then we're in the car, and everybody's like, yeah, Ryan got Raisin Bran. Mr. Finning goes, why the heck did he get Raisin Bran? And I'm like, I thought you would want Raisin Bran. And so I had to eat like the entire Raisin Bran box by myself, and it was not fun.
Think of the children in Africa.
Listen, Rice Krispies are not that great, okay?
Oh, lies!
Lies!
No, you're wrong.
Rice Krispies are okay.
They're so good.
They're so bland.
No, they make Rice Krispie treats. Does Raisin Bran do that?
Because there's marshmallows with rice. There's what?
Snap, crackle, pop, baby.
Make sure to get a hefty bunch of Raisin Bran.
I'm going to walk home, okay? This is...
Mr. Finning, that is a modern-style garbage can in a traditional style.
That is so true.
Awful.
Why do we have Raisin Bran? Who eats Raisin Bran?
No one.
No one eats Raisin Bran. Who picked out the Raisin Bran?
All right, let's... So we're here at The Mark. We're the first group to see a film. Right now we're waitlisting, so...
Over there you can see that it's getting long.
But we got good numbers, 73, 72, so...
Okay, we'll get in, yeah.
So. We got a good chance. Ryan's over there with 25. I think the movie's gonna be pretty good, but...
Yeah.
All right.
The car in the film is almost a character in itself. How did you decide what kind of car it is?
The question is about the car, asking the car.
Yeah, quite by accident. It was actually, that was the second place car. The first one we picked because it was exactly the car that I had in high school, which was like a 76 Pontiac Monteur. And on the first day of shooting, it just died.
So beautiful, too.
Yeah, and then we got it painted the same. I was like, I want the same color like I had in high school. It's got to be black and green. And then it died. And so we had that other one standing by, so we hustled that in. And it was just sort of like 20 minutes before we had to shoot that scene. I guess this is Ruth's car, but it sort of became Ellen in the story. And Melanie loved, just loved that car. Loved riding it and parking it.
I loved shutting the doors. It was so easy and smooth. Loved being in it, smelling the fumes.
Yeah.
I think we have time for one more question. So did you get to watch this movie tonight?
Yes.
Good.
I really liked it.
Did you like making the movie?
Yes.
Was it fun? Was everyone fun to work with?
Very.
You did a great job.
We're here with Hunter and Kat and Kayla. She's right there. Okay, and we're here to see The Little Hours, first movie of Sundance. Pretty psyched. Oh yeah. I'm pretty pumped. Okay, here we go.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Yo, what's up? This is Hunter coming at you. First movie of Sundance. I'm very excited. Little Hours. Big fan of Dave Franco.
Maybe
we'll see him. So yeah. Cool.
Question is, what's everyone's favorite scene? Maybe their favorite scene to shoot? For me, it was when the girls were getting drunk. It was just, the energy was great and it was really fun.
Yeah, that scene was like the weirdest sleepover. Like, we were like singing Lisa Loeb and I don't know what was going on, but we were having a great time.
Yeah. I was going to say that scene too. It was a really fun sleepover.
This is kind of a trick question for me because a lot of my scenes are pretty sexual and my fiance is standing right here, so
none of them.
I actually wasn't there on shooting that day, but my favorite scene is also when the girls get drunk.
That was my favorite scene to watch, for sure. But the scene that I was there for was when Nick is describing what he's going to do to Dave. Adam and I have to stand there and be quiet as Nick Offerman just describes the most f***ed up. Like, he went for 20 minutes unbroken about torture devices to the point where, I hope this might be saying this, but he should be on a watch list.
My favorite scene was working with, I just had a couple of them. I mean, and Dave, it was awesome to have you on top of me, but it was, and then like chatting about like, am I like your mother, or am I, you know, yeah, that's so and but working with Nick Offerman, that scene, every time he came around the corner with that napkin on his head, that diaper on his head, that made me laugh so hard. And his, that, anything, just anything comes out of his mouth, it's amazing. So I love that.
I liked so many of the scenes, but I really actually enjoyed being in the chapel services and getting fake communion, because I did that my entire life growing up, and there was something really kind of comforting about it.
My favorite scene was at the very, I'm giving a very serious answer. It was at the end with John C. Reilly and I on the bridge. I just thought it was so beautiful. I have never been in such a beautiful place in my life. And I just love that it's the end of the movie and it's like a celebration of that they could be themselves, no more hiding. I just thought it was so beautiful and the music makes my heart explode.
Okay, you like Hobby Story. Yeah, so basically it was me, Kat, Ryan, and Hunter, we were all in the YouTube store getting free coffee and churros, even though they were out of churros. And we were waiting for my latte, and there was this girl taking a selfie, and like we only saw her from the back, so like she looked pretty. This guy goes up to her, and he's like, "Oh, do you want me to take a better picture of you?" So, and she's like, "Yeah, sure." So she starts taking pictures and like putting, like, you know, he's flirting, really cute and stuff. And then we're like, "Oh, Hunter, like, get in there, go be smooth." And then his pickup line, like, he tells us his pickup line, "You like coffee?"
All right, guys, we just got out of the YouTube place, but even better than that,
this is amazing.
This bench is heated.
It's heated.
It's heated.
It's
heated.
It's so nice. My butt feels so
yeah.
good right now.
It's
like snowing it's
heated.
A lot, but
it's
like,
heated. Yeah, that's fine though, because our butts are fine.
Hey guys, it's the girls at Sock City. Woo. We have a little sock roast for you today.
Okay, so we decided to pick out some socks to describe everyone in the house, so I'll start with mine. Cheese.
Cheese. Of course.
Because, you know, you
she
know.
Has a problem.
Cheese. And then we got Jason. Who's sassy? Sassy F.
He's constantly sassy.
We have geek for me and nerd for Emma.
That's me.
Because we have so much homework and we're drowning it, but it's fine, everything's fine.
Send help.
And then for Hunter, fruit, because he's soft. And it was just funny.
For Ryan.
Daniel.
Ryan Daniel, we have trashy, because, I mean,
trash.
Pretty obvious, he's trash.
Do we need to explain that?
Then we've got, for Matt, we've got dork.
Just seem,
seem to work.
Yep. Yeah. And then for Ryan Burns,
the bear.
It's Pitt. Like pajamas that you put in water and it
expands.
It expands. And we gave him bear because he always got the bear in Pitt.
Every single time.
So yeah. He gets the bear
so
again.
Our apology for giving him the bear every time. So
hi.
Hey guys.
So we just got out of family life.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah.
Really good.
It was really
I feel
good.
So cultured now.
Yes. I feel very cultured.
The music was great. The score was really
yeah,
good.
Yeah. It was very so interesting.
The cat.
The cat. The cat. I felt a spiritual connection.
Mississippi.
His name was Mississippi.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, like, there's the poster.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Here's the poster.
So
yeah. It's all the same guy. Oh, wait.
Hi, guys. I'm a theater manager here at Prospector.
Oh, nice.
Hi people. One night, like, we were all in the house, and like we really didn't have much to do. So on my laptop I have a game called Quiplash, and it's just essentially a game where people make up answers and then you vote on who had the best answer to a question. Quiplash has a couple, like, I guess sister games that you can get. So I bought like the companion pack. All these games were like really fun. We tried to give them all a shot, and then other games Emma would just win over and over again and got very frustrated with that too. But there were a lot of good moments from that. I think it was a really good bonding experience, like all of us playing these new games, discovering more and more about each other. And I'd definitely go play these games with them again.
It was fun just staying at the house and hanging out with everyone, playing games. It was a really fun time.
You can't just take another one. You have to take that out.
Or at least put it back.
Oh my god, it's over.
Thank god.
That's it.
hearing Matt get shocked was hilarious. We just walk in the first day and you were ow, dang it! And we're like, what happened? He's like, I got shocked by the outlet. We're like, be careful. And then 2 minutes later you were ow, dang it! that was pretty funny.
4 minutes, people. Wait. 4 minutes.
So should I just do it by myself and not link with anyone? I'm okay with that. It's not the big deal.
Okay, everybody, get your waitlist on.
For some people, waitlisting was great. A lot of people waitlisted into 2 movies, 3 movies. I only waitlisted to, or at least got into 1 waitlisting. And the one problem we had with waitlisting was linking up. Every time we link with someone, it's supposed to give you and that person numbers right next to each other. So if you link up, you get number 60, the other person would get number 61. It's easy like that, but it didn't work. Every time you link up with someone, they wouldn't get a number, and they wouldn't be able to get into the movie, only you would. So, waitlisting was good, but when linking up, it was not.
Seriously,
it wasn't
look
worth
at
it.
This. Someone just, like, it's terrible.
That's how we found it last night.
Yeah. Can we throw it out? Because it's kind of nasty looking.
What is that?
It's like a happy
banana.
Happy banana. Someone didn't finish their banana.
Are you kidding me?
What kind of sick person?
It
was probably Ryan.
Finish.
He's probably getting
it.
Back at us for the Raisin Bran thing.
I would have, but I did not.
Wasting all the bananas, like you're wasting the Raisin Bran.
That's definitely something I would do. Though.
Hey
Hey guys, we're on our way to our first movies on Saturday.
Yeah.
Fab Four.
Fab
Four and Lame Two.
Fab Four and Hunter and Lame. What?
Fab Four and Lame Two.
Yes, Emma.
Okay. Her question was for all the actors. What are they doing to prepare for these roles? Do they do anything special?
Well, for me, it was sitting down. Charlie and Justin. And going through the script, went through page by page and talked about everything so that by the time we got there, it was more about figuring out what was going on between Looney and I and between all the actors. But I don't know, I probably feel like how you guys feel. I'm still processing what I just watched. It was a really intense experience. But yeah, I mean, for me, it was just trying to do nothing and pay attention to what everybody else was doing.
He said action. I read it and I thought it was an intriguing story, and when it's written well in an active way, you just, you know, just play what's on the page and don't try to overlay it with a lot of stuff. It seemed, you know, that there were scenes that you had to make work and you just tried to do them as they appear. Tell a story that was in front of you.
I think Charlie summed me up earlier, so I'll just say that the thrill for me was, first of all, appreciating the fact that Charlie chose me. He sought me out. I appreciated that because it's a part I like playing. And the other thing was, I just think that the joy that I had was working with these actors. And these are just such wonderful actors. And for me to be in the company of such wonderful actors gave me not only joy, but was inspiration.
Hello, we just finished watching The Discovery, which is a really, really good movie. One of probably my favorite far.
My mind definitely was blown.
Yeah.
The first scene had chills.
Chills.
Oh my god.
Throughout.
The audience was shocked. Let me tell you.
Yeah.
Definite watch.
I probably would have screamed.
Yeah. The Fab Four enjoyed it.
They didn't let us ask a question though. We had two questions.
Yeah.
Really. They just didn't call on us.
Ready.
The Fab Rep. I don't know.
The guy walked right in front of me.
Jason Segel was here.
Yeah. You know, there's a theater at Main Street, and you know, a bunch of people are being let out. And I see there's a kind of a commotion. I wasn't really paying attention. And as I'm walking down the street, I get bumped. And wouldn't you know it, I turn around, and there, like a foot in front of me, is Robert Redford. You know, the guy who made Sundance, who made all of it. I was freaking out because I was like, holy crap, it's Robert Redford! I was running over him and he was rushing to his car. It was just the coolest thing ever because I bumped into Robert Redford, the guy who made Sundance. You know, I bumped into the Sundance Kid. The Sundance Kid.
We are here at Sundance, freezing our asses off because of this terrible, terrible weather. And we're cold and we are now about to watch the Trump protest coming down. Yep, that's what we're doing. Fun, fun, fun. I want to get that chant down.
We are right in the middle of the march. It is crazy to say the least. It's not looking like it's going to end anytime soon. So, yeah, here we are. Still can't go into any of the stores. All of them are closed until this thing is over. So.
Hey guys, so this is the adventures of Emma and Mr. Finning. The Sundance buses aren't running, so we've been walking in the snow for like half an hour. And we're gonna try to figure out a way to get to Killing Ground. Wish us luck.
Hey everyone, we just got out of Killing Ground. Pretty great movie. What'd you guys think?
Pretty brutal.
Yeah. It was disturbing.
It's pretty hardcore.
Wow. He's dying?
Yeah, it was
don't spoil it.
We don't know it. Pretty intense.
Yeah.
I didn't really expect that.
It was good though.
It was Aussies.
It was different. Yeah,
nice. Director was great. The actors were awesome.
They're very nice.
Yeah.
One of them left me a note. Pretty cool.
Welcome back to Fireside Chats. As always, I'm Hunter Coe, and I'm here again with Jason Pernicero. Thank you for being here, Jason. I'd like to thank our sponsors first. Arnold Palmer,
and our new sponsor, Water. Water. Can't live without it. Now, Jason, me and you saw a movie, an Australian film called Killing Ground. Now, what would you say your favorite part about the film was? It was very intense. Very intense. Are you all right there? Would you like some water?
No,
okay.
My favorite part, I think, would have to be... Baby Slam Dunk.
Baby Slam Dunk.
Baby
now,
slam
why would you say that?
Well, it's a mystery. It's actually a riddle, if you would, for the audience. But for those of you who have seen it, Baby Slam Dunk is a very valid and important part of this featured film.
I'd have to agree. Thank you very much, Jason. Welcome back to Fireside Chat. I'm here with Ryan Byrne. And as always, we'd like to thank our sponsors beforehand. We are sponsored by Arnold Palmer and Jason Panizziera. Jason, salutations. Now, Ryan, we saw a film called Killing Ground last night. Did you enjoy it? It was a foreign film, Australian.
I would say it was a slam.
Oh, I might, yeah. And the Bobby.
Yes.
So you'd say you enjoyed Killing Ground?
I'd say it was a slam dunk.
A slam dunk. What was your favorite part, you think?
You know, probably the original baby scene.
Original baby scene with the shot?
The walking shot.
That was a very nice shot. I got it. It was very good.
Yeah.
When the toddler was walking in the background. I thought it was very good. Very well done.
Yes.
Now, did you have any... it was a very disturbing film. Wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, it was very disturbing.
Yes. Did that turn you off at all?
I thought some parts it definitely did.
Yes. Okay. Well, thank you. Yes, I agree. It was a bit disturbing at times, but thank you very much again, Ryan. It was a pleasure to have you.
Nice to meet
you. Welcome back to Fireside Chats. I am Hunter Ho, as always, and today I am with Ryan Daniel.
Ryan Daniel.
Yes, Ryan Daniel. Thank you very much, Ryan, for being here. So, we saw Killing Ground yesterday.
Killing Ground. Yes, we did.
Yes. What was your opinion on that movie?
Boy, Killing Ground. Boy, it was thrilling. You know, there wasn't a single boring moment in that movie right from the start. It just
very thrilling. How do you feel about the non-linear timeline?
You know, I think the non-linear timeline was brilliant. I think in a thriller, it's very rough to do, but we saw it in Memento, and I thought it worked well in Killing Ground.
I agree. I thought it was a very smart film. The director clearly knew what he was doing.
Absolutely.
The cast... Although they were kind of unknown, I thought they did a very nice job.
Yeah, Australian town. Some of them were known.
Yes, we had some of our group go up to them after, get some pictures, autographs. Very nice people, wonderful.
Yes.
So that's about it. Ryan, thank you so much for coming today.
You're welcome.
Ryan, as always, we'd like to thank our sponsors again. Thank you to Arnold Palmer. Wonderful drink, wonderful.
Monopoly, wonderful game.
Monopoly,
wonderful game.
All right, thank you so much.
That is unprofessional, to be honest with you.
Excuse me.
That's
cool. I think you're just upset because you lost the Monopoly today.
Oh, is that what this is? Because I think your cameraman is not working.
You
camera.
You know what? Yeah, all right, buddy. Can we get security in here, please? Can we get security, please?
I'm doubling on the...
Come on, please.
Get him! Kill the Monopoly!
Security! Security!
I'm not...
Hey, guys. Hello. So we're waitlisting here for Before I Fall, and it's pretty empty right now, so we're really excited about that.
Yeah, we're at Eccles Theater, so there should be a lot of seats.
You know, over 1,000.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
There's, like, no one here, and...
They closed the door in 15 minutes, so...
Yep. So we're hoping that we'll get in.
Alright.
Did being part of this film or anything change the way you live your everyday life?
I'll speak to that for 1 second before John does. Since I was with Lauren's book before it was even published, and with the materials for such a long time, what guided me the whole time was the idea that the important lesson is that not doing something bad is not the same as doing something good, which I think is a choice all of us now face in particular, with a poignancy and a power that we might not have thought of a mere 10 weeks ago. So, I definitely have been thinking about that for a really long time. Does it mean that I have changed my life completely? I mean, I think I'm a little nicer.
Getting into that movie was incredibly lucky because originally, I remembered to waitlist
30 seconds before we got everyone on or a couple people on. And so then Ryan Byrne, he was the one who actually got a good waitlist number. And then I get in and they tell me I had to get out of the line because I wasn't Ryan Byrne. And then outside, I got scalped a ticket, so I got in. It was a little bit more expensive, but I got in. And the movie turned out to be fantastic. It was very good.
Anybody else? There's a lady all the way in the back there.
Me?
Somebody, I think, would have a white hat on.
Oh, this dude.
Yeah.
Me? Oh, sorry.
Yeah, all the way back.
Go ahead. Excuse me.
Okay. Oh,
here.
Oh, well, yeah, up in the balcony.
I'll try again.
That's okay. Yeah, that person in the back there. Yeah.
Stand up.
So
what words of advice would you have for young filmmakers to create such an inspiring message that movie offered for us?
I would say, like, don't start with a message. Just start with a character. Start with, like, a character that won't get out of your head. Like, start with, like, you know, and if you find a character, if it's not your material, like, find a character that you connect to. So when you start out trying to leave a message, I think it pushes people away. So I think start with relationships. And the thing I loved about this film was the opportunity for all these relationships and these families constantly bouncing off each other. And, like, that's what I was excited about, the multiple perspectives. So I think just find characters that you love, find material that you love, and just really get into the relationships. Like, just keep finding, like, the core. Just, to me, that's what makes people feel something, not trying to say something necessarily.
Welcome back to Fireside Chats. I'm here with Matthew Beal, and as always, before we begin, we'd like to thank our sponsors for the episode. As always, thank you, Arnold Palmer, and we also have our new sponsor, Eggo Homestyle Waffles. Delicious. For the on-the-go working man who doesn't have time to sit down and eat breakfast with his family, an Eggo waffle. You enjoying your waffle there? Wonderful, wonderful. Now, Matthew, last night you saw a pretty late movie, you'd say, yes?
Yes.
What was the movie?
Saw Mudbound.
Mudbound. And am I aware that was at the top of your list?
Yes, it was.
How'd you like it?
On a scale of 1 to 10?
Uh-huh.
A plus.
Get out of here. You're filthy.
Get that camera out of my face.
You're filthy. You are disgusting.
We're running.
Take a shot.
We're running.
Welcome back to Fireside Chat. I'm here with Matthew Beal again. Matthew, it is great to have you.
Hello.
Thank you. As always, we'd like to thank our sponsors beforehand. Thank you to Arnold Palmer and our new sponsor today, LaCroix.
Yeah.
L.A. Crocs. Seltzer. Get some bubbly in ya. So Matthew, yesterday you saw the animation short film.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
What do you think of that? Are you a big fan of animation?
I love animation very much, and I'd say that now I don't.
That's quite a shame. I had the same experience when I saw the shorts program. It was a bit disappointing. One or two gems in there, but that was about it. Would you say the same for the animation?
There were definitely some highlights within it, but overall, there are a lot of weird things. Like,
okay.
Like claymation rape, that was not okay.
Oh, okay. Well, thank you. Again, our sponsors for this episode were Arnold Palmer, as always, and L.A. Crocs. Get out of here. Get out of here. You are garbage. You are a garbage person. You are a trash.
Everyone's waitlisting for The Hero and or Colossal.
We're starting with
it's for Colossal.
It's for Colossal.
Thank you very much.
Okay, right, it's for Colossal.
15 seconds.
Oh no.
That took a while. 15 seconds. Here we go, baby.
Here we go.
Ten.
So
got
nine.
I don't know if we got a good number. That took a little bit.
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know.
Numbers exceeded.
Numbers exceeded.
208.
208's not going to do it.
No, it's not going to do it.
You have two people in front of you that left the wait list.
I didn't even get a wait list number.
Damn.
Yikes. That went out fast. This is the premiere. All right, wait listing for The Hero now. Hunter's really getting ready here.
Okay. 10 seconds.
Now I have 10. What am I behind?
I'm at 5.
Nine.
Numbers exceeded.
Wait.
Damn it!
Wait, I got numbers exceeded too.
My numbers exceeded.
81.
I really wanted to see that.
Oh! What? Mr. Fing!
How did you go by yourself or?
No, I linked with Emma.
Damn it!
Is it showed up?
When in doubt, go with the teachers, because the level got 19, you got 81.
I don't see.
What'd you get, Ron?
Do you not see Emma's number?
Do you not see Emma's number? That keeps happening.
That's been happening.
But I linked with her.
Yeah, that's what happened with me and Matt this morning.
Hot tub.
I like it.
Yeah,
I like it.
Right. He went in the hot tub.
I don't know. I had the stupid idea to run around the house. So I ran around the house alone in my bathing suit in like 2.5 feet of snow, probably around there. It was awful and I was sinking and the ice like cut up my feet and it was miserable and my feet were just numb. And then Matt went and he ran around the house and he said it was equally miserable. So then we had the idea, the very, very smart idea to race around the house. It was me, Jason, Matt, and Ryan. And we just raced around the house in our bathing suits, and the loser had to do a snow angel and in the middle of the snow, and it was just awful. But I mean, it wasn't me, so happy about that. But it was just, it was a good bonding experience, I'd say that. Would I do it again? No. Actually, you know, I'd do it again. It was fun. It was a good time, good time.
Hi guys, we're playing Pit.
Yeah, we are.
Mr. Finning won the first round, which is kind of suspicious, because he's the veteran player.
Who has the platinum?
That was me.
What do you have? Oil, 65 points.
I got the goddamn parrot.
Yes.
And what I like best about it is I gave it to him.
Shut up.
Yes.
Okay. Jason's enjoying his game. Okay, he was.
What happens?
I'd say my favorite experience was probably chilling at home, probably at night. The nights were most fun.
At night, we spent a lot of time like cooking, working together, playing games, and then especially, most importantly, watching Bob Ross, which was very important to all of us.
Mr. Finning, for some reason, just starts to rail and rip on Bob Ross.
We are watching Bob Ross right now. Mr. Finning over here has like a thing against Bob Ross.
I hate Bob Ross.
Okay, thank you. First step is admitting it. The second step is trying to get through it.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely. I have nobody for my own.
Are you looking to direct other projects as well, or are you primarily thinking to sticking to screenwriting?
I mean, screenwriting is a lot easier. You know, you get some wine, put on some music. Directing is really a miserable experience in every way. But no, there's stories you want to tell, and you want to see them all the way through, and that's the only way to do it.
And in terms of taking on this project as your first one, just talk a little bit about the challenges of jumping into that directorial role. Like, I mean, you film it in winter, it can't be the most easy on a production level.
No, it was the worst first film to do. We shot it in 30 days at 11,000 feet, most of it. And, it was cameras freeze, actors freeze. It was really hard. But I think that in a certain way, it forced the crew and the cast to really kind of bond because it was a long way to make the day. And I think that effort shows on the screen. I think it feels earned.
Just talk a little bit about the casting and sort of how you decided to work, or how you cast it together.
The role of Corey, I said I want Jeremy Renner, and they're like, well, he's doing, Arrival. A year later, I still hadn't cast it, and then he was available, and so it worked out. I'd known I wanted Lizzie from the beginning. I knew I wanted. I wrote the role for Grant Green.
Okay.
Never thinking I would get him. And then I called. I was like, hey, you want to do it? And he's like, yeah, okay. It's extremely anticlimactic. And then the cast just fell into place.
Welcome back to Fireside Chats. I'm here with Jason Princiero. As always, our sponsors are Arnold Palmer and Pop-Tarts. Today, we will be talking about the movies that were seen today at the Sundance 2017 Film Festival. Jason, as you know, we both saw Wind River today. Mm. What was your opinion of it?
I found the movie to be quite fascinating and exhilarating at the same time. It was action-packed.
You good?
Okay. Yes. It was action-packed and had a lot of drama and thrills. And it gave me chills.
Yes, yes,
yes, quite. What was your interpretation of the film?
Oh, I would definitely say it was the best movie I've seen so far at Sundance. Is your popcorn good?
It's very good. Very good.
As always, we'd like to remind our viewers we're sponsored by Arnold Palmer and Pop-Tarts. Ah. Welcome back to Fireside Chats. I'm here with Ryan Byrne. We would like to thank our sponsors for this episode. As always, we have Arnold Palmer. Thank you very much. And today, our new sponsor is Fran's Whole Wheat Buns. Fran's, get some fun in your bun. Now, Ryan, we both saw Wind River today.
That we did.
It was a fantastic movie, in my opinion. What do you think?
It was very good. It was shot really well. There was a lot of very interesting scenes.
Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes. I agree completely. Would you say rank it out of 10?
11.
11? Ladies and gentlemen, 11. That is 1-1. Beautiful, beautiful. Now, Ryan, what is your favorite part about Fran's buns?
Everything.
Everything?
Everything.
Would you say the flaky texture or just how it melts in your mouth?
How it melts in your mouth,
of
course.
Oh, boy. Welcome back to Fireside Chats. I'm here with Ryan Daniel. As always, we'd like to take a second to thank our sponsors of this episode. As always, Arnold Palmer. And we'd like to thank
Ryan's Raisin Bran.
I don't want to give anything away, Hunter.
Okay. As always,
but there was a certain scene where the protagonist got the upper hand. And that scene was just fantastic.
I agree. I saw many people in the audience started cheering and clapping. Even at the end of the movie, the audience gave the director a standing ovation.
A standing ovation.
It was beautiful, really beautiful.
Because Wind River was excellent.
Unfortunately, director Chris Stenders couldn't be with us today as he's working on another project, but we do have producer Nelson Wass here in the house to come up and say a few words before the screening. Nelson?
I have had the privilege and opportunity to see other films, and I'm not sure whether it was coincidence or whatever, but the films are unbelievable, but they have been a little dark. So if you're expecting cannibalism, incest, or war crimes, you might be in the wrong cinema.
So all we ask is, if you like that film, please spread the word, make as much noise, and do me a favor, if you didn't like it, don't say anything.
Also, if you like it, that's a prequel. The next film is Red Dog, which you can get on Netflix. I don't know if you have Netflix, it's not too low anymore. That was a very bad joke. I'll play make up for that in a minute. The film Red Dog is a beautiful film, and it's on Netflix, and I recommend you watch it.
It was it's the highest grossing Australian film, the original Red Dog.
I don't care about money.
I'm just saying. Just trying to convey about how popular the film is in the story. I mean, I wasn't aware of the Red Dog legend until I saw this film and did research, and I mean, it's a really remarkable story, so.
Yeah, there really was a Red Dog, and he roamed around northwest, very remote part of the outback in northwest Australia. And if you go to a town of Dampier, there really is a Red Dog statue because he brought the community together. It was a very disparate outback community, and he was his symbol. But no one knew where he came from. And this was a film that we made for our kids after we did the first one to try and imagine where he came from.
Welcome back to Fireside Chats. I am here because I'm Hunter Coe, and I am here with my dear friend Kayla. Now, Kayla, thank you very much. Kayla.
You're a sweet guy.
Kayla.
Yes.
As always, you've seen the show before, we have to thank our sponsors. As always, Arnold Palmer, thank you very much. And Western Family Cheese.
Family Company.
When you're not in the West, East, or North, get West. Red Dog True Blue. I am a dog person myself. I love dogs. Do you like dogs, Kayla?
Yeah, I have a dog.
Yes. Did you like the movie?
It was fantastic.
It was fantastic.
Good for families.
Good for family. Would you say it was a family movie?
Yes. Absolutely.
Oh, lovely.
They only cursed once in the movie.
They only cursed once?
Uh-huh.
What was it? What would you say? Like, bad curse? Like, it's a
bitch. It's fine.
Okay, bitch, that's fine. That's not even that. You don't have to bleep that. We can keep that in.
I saw that movie too.
Yeah, bitch. How do you. Okay, well, two in one. All right, bitch. How do you feel about bitch? The movie
that
bitch.
Also about a dog.
Bitch.
Okay.
Except it's about a woman turning into a dog.
It was good? Well, yeah. What do you like about it?
There was a lot of cursing in that
movie.
I really enjoyed that.
Yeah. What was it? What genre do you think?
It's a little bit of everything.
Okay. That's, you know what? That's very nice sometimes. Films need to be like that sometimes. As always, I'd like to thank our sponsors for this episode. Arnold Palmer, as always, and we're not gonna get the money anymore. I don't know what was so funny about that. They're not gonna sponsor us anymore. Can you get off my set?
Hey guys, we out here in the Wilson premiere line.
There's no one here.
Yeah.
We're really early.
We're all
throwback
by ourselves.
To Mr. Finning.
Yeah, throwback
night.
To Robmeister all alone.
it's lit. If it keeps up like this.
Yeah.
Great.
That'd be lovely if it was literally us three. We got like our own section.
Well, we're like an hour early. It's like Mr. Finning last night.
Doodling in Jason's book, Doodle Rob.
He didn't even get in though. Wait, that's what he said.
But we're getting in. We're getting in.
You got this.
I really hope we get in.
We will unleash the rage of mass media students. We don't.
We are here at Wilson, Jason's favorite movie.
Wanted to see this all day. Woody Harrelson, man.
Yeah, I can't wait. I hope we see Woody Harrelson for sure.
I really hope we see Woody Harrelson. Yeah.
Anything, Hunter?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm. A little bit.
It's gonna be.
Mm. I'm hoping for big things.
Yeah.
Sure. I think it's gonna be pretty funny.
Awesome. Uh-huh.
Possibly.
Yep.
Okay.
Slightly.
You guys, I got into the Wilson premiere. Kayla gave me her ticket. She's the nicest person on the planet. I'm so excited. I'm walking up to the balcony.
Your friend?
These just to all the actors. What did you do to kind of prepare for all your roles?
Well, from my perspective, we're all similar to the roles in our own ways, you know? Like, we're not exactly the characters, but like a lot about acting is like putting yourself into the character and making it your own. So I took the time and I went through the script and I really just thought about, you know, if I was in this position, how would I react to this? And a lot of it happens on set for me, like, and a lot of my work, just reacting to like what Woody does and what both Judy and Cheryl and Laura all do. A lot of my work happens on set, so that's how I do it.
Get up. Well, I mean, I really thought that both the graphic novel and then the screenplay, which both Craig and Daniel worked on, was really, it kind of held the character. You could really tell almost everything you needed. You had all the information, and I kind of related to the guy right away. I mean, I have a gregarious side like him. I guess I have a curmudgeon-y side like him.
Decide upon setting the tone for the movie, because obviously you see a lot of change from the beginning to the end of it.
Yeah, well, tone in any movie is critical, but when you're balancing comedy and a little bit of darkness, but with actual emotion and humanity, tone is critical, and we worked endlessly on trying to find that balance. I took a lot of cues from Daniel's graphic novel. There was a visual template there set, and they sort of just, you know, there's realism, and then, you know, there's maybe one gently elevated step up, and that might be the zone that we're in. It's often in the editing, honestly, that it all comes together. Music was critical, and it's not until sort of the final piece of color correction that tone finally comes together, and often the tone tells, you know, the movie tells you what the tone will be, and not until the very end.
I think one of the coolest experiences I had at Sundance was meeting Woody Harrelson. I was getting really nervous because the day we went, it was coming down hard with all the snow, and I was afraid that they were going to cancel on us. But wouldn't you know, they actually got there right as the movie ended, thankfully, and you know, Woody Harrelson right in front of me, two rows in front of me, there he was standing there. So I rushed over there. I was like, Woody, I'm like, what are your biggest fans? I need an autograph. Give me an autograph. I need a picture. Give me a picture. And wouldn't you know it, I got a picture with Woody Harrelson and I got an autograph from him. He said, Jason, you know, stay cool, Woody Harrelson. I keep it upstairs in my room with the picture right next to it, and I love it. And it was one of the coolest experiences ever.
Hi.
Dress before
No. So we just saw Wilson. The waitlist line was really intense, but we got in.
I got so much anxiety. I was like cutting it really close. I missed like the first few minutes, but like it was definitely worth it.
Yeah, it was worth it to wait. And it was good. It was funny.
It was really, yeah. Woody Harrelson was there.
Yeah, and Laura Dern and all the other stars were there, so that's cool. And the writer and the director. So yeah, now we're waiting for our car.
And it's really cold.
Yeah, it's really cold, and the roads are really bad. So wish us luck.
All right, so here we are. We're back at the house. And we just found out that we won't be seeing Bushwick tonight because it's like a blizzard out there. So, how are you feeling, guys?
I mean, it's a lot of people's top movies, so it's definitely disappointing. But under the circumstances, I'd rather not get stuck in the middle of dying.
Sundance is great, so, but death sucks.
Yeah, death sucks. Sundance is great. I think I'd rather.
Hey guys, we're about to play Monopoly.
I'm having some fruit snacks.
Because he's a fruit.
Because I'm a fruit. And I'm soft apparently.
Hashtag soft.
Yeah, it's gonna be pretty intense. Well, we all did our part in cooking, preparing the meals.
We got Ryan here
making the mac and cheese,
making macaroni and cheese.
Best mac and cheese anyone's ever had.
There was a lot of cooking that happened like every night, especially the big dinners. There was always a lot of food, always salad and burgers, hot dogs, stuff like that.
Tension in the
20
kitchen.
Seconds.
We have a wet bar too. We can.
To hit you with these?
Do
like,
it.
Is that what you're asking?
Do it.
Whoa!
Do it. Do it.
Let's be nice.
And we got Galembo slaving over the grill outside.
We didn't eat out a lot, maybe a couple times during lunch, but it was fun having everyone there at night and participating in the meal, so I thought that was a good thing.
What kind of research did you do for this role?
Well, you know, I had the advantage of this amazing documentary that I could watch over and over again and study and watch the real Jan Levon do his thing. And there's tons of YouTube videos of Jan. And I went down long, long wormholes of YouTube polka musicians, which I highly recommend. There's some insane musicianship in the lost art known as polka. But yeah, I guess that's my main research.
Yes.
So it was on the last day that we were going into town, and I was walking with Madame, and we were going to the Sundance merchandise store, and we walked past Woody Harrelson. I was just like, wait a second, that was Woody Harrelson, and Madame was like, wait, you have to run back and get a picture with him. So I like followed him down the street, and I was like, hi, I just saw the Wilson premiere yesterday, can I take a picture with you? So I took a selfie with him and sent it to everyone, and Madame was proud of me that I spotted him, and it was a good day. But we couldn't find him again after that, we lost him.
Where's this at?
Also, I'm screwed. Is that good?
It depends. I heard someone talking about how people at the end of the line got
What was your number?
96.
348.
These guys are horrible.
This is a question for any of the cast. What drew you to the project?
The script was crazy. I read it and it was like the most creative thing I had ever read, and I forwarded it to a friend and I was like, you have to check this out, this is insane.
My agent John Sachs said it's his litmus test for whether somebody's down or not. So, and when I got to the line where he says, what's your shirt? It's Brigsby. And then it says, it's Brigsby. I was like, I'm in.
My little cousin Paisley actually read the script and gave a tip to us on that specific joke. It didn't say it's Brigsby in the script on the shirt. And she sent me an email and was like, you should make it say it's Brigsby on the shirt. And it was so simple and so brilliant. I like scripts that you can't categorize easily. You know, your agent will call and say, I have a script. It's Die Hard in a supermarket, you know?
whatever, you know, it's always compared to something else. I read this thing and I thought, this is really original. And I had lines. So, already, that appealed to me.
Mark Hamill was like this close to my face, and that was great. I didn't get to talk to him technically, but he was right there, which is awesome, so.
Hey guys, it's Hunter. Coming at ya, it's the last night. We got everyone over here. We got Matt over here. We got, oh, can't flip the camera, gotta go like this. Hey guys, what's up? It's kinda, a little bit dark. Easy everyone, say your names.
Just do anything
at the same
point.
Time. Good job, guys.
Yeah!
Awesome, we got Ryan over here. We got everyone over here. All right guys, good job. I'm Hunter, by the way. Had a great time, now see ya.
This is the final vlog of Sundance. It's Tuesday morning, we're about to go home. It's pretty sad.
Very sad,
everybody.
Sad day.
Yes,
last year,
certainly went.
Memorable. I'm pretty sad, but I also believe in miracles.
One of my favorite movie was The Discovery. The Discovery.
Mudbound.
Wind River.
Wind River.
Wind River. Maybe Brigsby Bear.
I gotta say it's a tie between Wind River or Wilson.
My overall experience, I have to say, it was like very good, very positive. A lot of it wasn't really what I was expecting, which added to the thrill of it, just like coming in blind, but being able to experience all these wonderful things, meeting all these famous actors, getting to hang out with some good friends. So I really found it to be an enjoyable experience.
I thought it was amazing. I love Sundance. I mean, the movies, I saw the most movies, by the way, 7 movies. and like the house was gorgeous and the hot tub was amazing. So I had a great time.
Overall experience, I would say fantastic. A+, 10 out of 10. Perfection. It was a great time. Loved it.
I purposefully went into the trip with little expectations just so that I could be even more pleasantly surprised because I knew it was going to be a great trip. And I was right to do that because it was an outstanding trip. It was one of the best 5 days of my entire life. It was so much fun.
Honestly, it was one of the best experiences I had in my life. Like, I've been on like other trips going to like Europe for like band or like Canada, but like this was the most fun because I got to watch a bunch of movies and got to spend time with like awesome people, and it was just overall a really good experience that I didn't get anywhere else.
Oh, I mean, the experience, it was a blast. I mean, you know, we got to hang in an expensive house, watch movies the entire time, eat food, meet famous people. I miss it. I want to go back there, man.
I think we had a pretty good group this year. I certainly enjoyed myself. It was a nice small group, but it was exciting. Some things never happened before, like 3 feet of snow. And I just think we bonded, the group really bonded. It was a nice group and everybody really came together. And I know I enjoyed it, and I'm sure everyone else did as well. I know the chaperones did as well, Mr. G and Madame Beaumier. Sad part about it is this is going to be Madame's last Sundance because she is retiring. We didn't know that when she was on the trip, so we didn't realize it was her last year. So that's kind of bittersweet that she's gone on the trip now for the past how many years. So we'll be missing her next Sundance if we go next year. That's for sure.